встречи к участникам встречи обратился Михаил Сергеевич Горбачев.
Then the participants were addressed by Михаил Сергеевич Горбачев.
Уважаемые дамы и господа,
ladies and gentlemen,
товарищи,
comrades.
Наверное, с тех самых пор,
probably,
как человек,
from the very first time,
впервые задумался,
that man first took thought
о завтрашнем дне,
about tomorrow,
лучшие умы разных
the best minds of all nations,
неизменно задавались
have constantly
вопросом,
wondered
о судьбах мира,
about the
о
future of mankind and the fate of the world.
Вплоть до относительно недавнего
until quite
времени,
recently, this kind of thinking,
размышления на эти и связанные с ними темы воспринимались как
was viewed
игра ума,
as an intellectual exercise on the part of philosophers, scholars,
ученых,
and theologians
богословов.
Who were remote from everyday human cares and concerns.
Последние десятилетия проблемы
But in the last few decades, these problems
сугубо практической
have become strictly practical ones.
Причины понятны,
the reasons for this,
каждому,
I think, are obvious to everyone here.
Создание,
the invention,
а затем и накопление
and the accumulation
за всякие разумные пределы ядерного
of nuclear weapons beyond all reasonable levels,
доставки,
as well as the means of their delivery,
сделали человека
have made man capable
способным положить конец
of his own
своему собственному существованию.
Physical destruction.
Одновременно
At the same time, the accumulation in the world
of socially explosive material
and attempts to continue to solve by force problems of a world that has changed beyond recognition by means inherited from the Stone Age have made a political catastrophe highly likely. The militarization of thinking
образа жизни
of ways of life
weakens
or removes altogether the moral restraints
на пути к ядерному самоубийству.
On nuclear suicide.
Мы не имеем права забывать.
We must not forget
первый шаг к этому
that the first step towards that
всегда самый рискованный
always the most risky has already been taken.
Ядерное оружие было практически применено против людей
have already been used
применено дважды
twice in fact against people.
Документально установлены
There is documentary
и признаны
proof. And it has been acknowledged that there have been dozens, and I repeat, dozens of cases where the possibility of using nuclear weapons against other countries has been seriously contemplated. I do not say this in the spirit of criticism or condemnation, although both would be amply justified. Nevertheless, the United Nations is functioning.
Существуют региональные
There are
и иные структуры международных
structures for international contacts,
которых раньше не
which
было.
Did not exist previously.
Словом, продолжается
In other words,
политический поиск
the political search
вывода
is continuing for a way of freeing the world community
из порочной логики,
from the vicious circle of logic
мировым войнам.
Which has led to world wars in the past.
После же войны ядерной
After a nuclear war, of course,
никаких проблем не
no
осталось.
Problems would remain.
Некому будет садиться
There would not be anyone left to sit
за пень, за
at even a tree stump or a stone for negotiations, let alone around a
Второй
table.
Ковчег не выйдет
There would
из
be no second
потока.
Noah's Ark to survive a nuclear flood.
Разумом это, пожалуй, понимаю.
Intellectually, this is not difficult
Все
to грасп
понимаю.
For anyone.
Дело за тем, чтобы
The problem
осознать.
Is to realize,
рассчитывать, что
to
все
understand
образуется само собой,
that events can
уже
no longer
нельзя.
Be allowed to take their own course.
Но в мире немало еще людей,
The truth is,
которые именно так
there
и думают.
There are still people who think precisely in this way.
Необходимо, не откладывая
We must,
более,
without further delay,
приводить международное
sure
общение, поведение правительств и государств
в соответствии
с реальностями ядерного
are governed by the realities of the nuclear age.
Да, вопрос стоит именно так.
And the issue is
Либо
really this.
Политическое мышление
Either political thinking
придет в соответствии
must be consistent with
времени,
the realities of the day, or civilization and life on earth may disappear.
Во всех делах человечества,
In all human affairs,
тем более международной
and particularly
политики,
international politics,
ни на минуту нельзя забывать
we must not be allowed
о доминирующей
for a moment
линии
to forget
над всем противоречии.
A choice of alternatives, which overshadows everything else.
Между существованием и небытием.
Existence or non-existence. For
mankind. Разрешить его.
And we must resolve this situation in time and in favor of peace.
А для этого надо выявлять,
to that end, we must identify, nurture,
делиться друг с другом
and share with each other the best that
истории,
has been achieved in the past,
искать новые творческие
and find
подходы
new creative approaches to old problems.
Не только прогресс рода
it is not only the progress of the human race, but its very survival.
Зависит от
that
того,
depends
найдем ли мы в себе
on whether we can find within ourselves the strength and courage
угрозы,
to banish the danger threatening the world today.
Полагаю,
and I believe that there is reason to suppose that we can.
Самые последние десятилетия
recent decades
тем, что
have been marked by the fact that for the fact
что на него со всех концов земли съехалось такое количество
eminent persons
знаменитых и авторитетных людей. Мы понимаем, у каждого свои обязанности, свои дела, тем не менее вы их отложили и за тысячи километров приехали сюда, чтобы заявить о своих тревогах и беспокойстве, поделиться мыслями с людьми, которых волнуют те же проблемы. Уже одно это само по себе значительно, ибо в составе участников форума представители разных слоев населения, люди со всех континентов, из многих десятков государств. Форум поистине олицетворение мировой общественности. Советским людям близки и понятны идеи форума, заботы и настроения, которые привели вас сюда. Именно в этом духе я еще раз обращаюсь к вам со словами приветствия и признательности за проделанную вами в эти дни работу, о чем рассказали представители всех круглых столов. И думаю,
I believe that the voice of this forum and the voices of each of you individually will be heard sooner or later. We are particularly encouraged by the fact that with all the differences in viewpoint, in positions and opinions, and attitudes to various issues, the forum has been marked by a common desire to join forces in the struggle against the nuclear threat and to solve other global problems facing mankind. What is important is for the idea of the forum and its very spirit to reach the widest possible circles of public and political opinion. And what is even more important, that it should be reflected in the actions of national decision makers. This is a wish, I believe, which was expressed by all representatives here at your plenary meeting in the Great Hall of the Kremlin. The Soviet government, for its part, will bear very much in mind everything that has been said here at this forum, here in Moscow. Nor could it be otherwise, because these ideas vitally affect the future of mankind. As to the problems discussed at this forum, I do have some things to say, and I would like to share with you the views of our government. But first of all, I'd like to make the following point. You come to the Soviet Union at a time of what is, in essence, a revolutionary change. Change of tremendous importance to our own society and socialism as a whole and to the whole world. And it is only by understanding the sense, content, and purposes of this change that you can properly judge our international policy. It is with a full sense of responsibility that I say to my people, to you, and to the whole world that our international policy, more than ever before, is determined by domestic policy, by the fact that our interest lies in concentrating on the constructive task of improving life in our own country.
Именно поэтому нам
and
нужны прочные меры,
предсказуемость
и конструктивная направленность международных отношений. Часто говорят, это мы слышим
now,
до сих пор,
a lot of talk, even
об угрозе,
about
якобы
kind of
исходящей от СССР, о советской угрозе
and the Soviet threat to peace and freedom.
Так вот, перестройка, которую
but
мы начали с таким размахом, и которая необратима,
on such a scale,
показывает
and which is irreversible,
всем,
makes it clear to everyone what are the tasks to which we want to devote our resources and the endeavors to which our thoughts are turned. These are our real programs and intentions. These are the objectives upon which we intend to expend the intellectual energies of our society. Our main goal is to tap the potential of socialism by harnessing all the resources within our people. For this, we need all our state and public organizations to be fully operative and fully functioning, as well as all productive elements and constructive forces in our society. We need new forms of activity on the part of citizens, and we need to bring back those forms which have been wrongly discarded. In a word, we need the broad democratization of the whole life of our society. And it is this which is the main guarantee of the irreversibility of the process we have begun. We want more socialism, and therefore more democracy. This is how we are continuing to advance the cause of our great revolution, and our people have responded enthusiastically. To prevent any idle talk or speculation, and there's a good deal of this in the West, I'd like to make this point. Our reforms have been chosen according to our own socialist criteria. On the basis of our own ideas of social values, guided by the norms of the socialist way of life. We measure our successes and failures by socialist yardsticks, and socialist yardsticks alone. But we want to be understood, and we hope that the whole world will finally realize that our objective of making ours a better country is something that will do harm to no one, and that the whole world can only benefit from it. The policy of change, to focus on its international aspect, is socialism's invitation to peaceful competition with any other social system. And we can prove, indeed, that this kind of competition can only promote general progress and peace throughout the world. But to ensure that this competition assumes a civilized form, worthy of mankind in the 21st century, there must be new thinking. We must break the old molds of stereotyped and dogmatic thinking inherited from bygone days. This problem of new thinking is something with which our society and the Soviet leadership has been grappling for some time now. And we've given it a lot of thought. We've criticized ourselves and others. We have asked ourselves difficult and painful questions before we were able to see the facts for what they were, and came to realize that in today's complex and contradictory world, which had reached a parting of the ways, what was needed were new approaches and methods of solving international problems. We came to conclusions which forced us to take a look at things which had seemed axiomatic up to then. Because after Hiroshima and Nagasaki, World War had ceased to be the continuation of politics by other means. In a nuclear war, those responsible for those policies would themselves be consumed in its flames. We finally came to understand that ultimately, with the accumulation and increasing sophistication of nuclear weapons, the human race had lost its immortality. The only way to get it back is to destroy nuclear weapons. We rejected the right of the leaders of any country whatsoever, whether it be the USSR or the USA or any other, to pronounce a death sentence on mankind. We are not judges, nor are billions of people around the world criminals for us to punish. It is for this reason that we must destroy the nuclear guillotine. The nuclear powers must pass through their nuclear shadows into the clear sunlight of a nuclear-free world, and by so doing, stop conducting politics outside the framework of the norms of human morality. The nuclear firestorm will sweep from the face of the earth socialists and capitalists, saint and sinner alike. Can this situation be considered moral? We communists say no. For us, the new thinking was no easy accomplishment. Its purpose is to obliterate the distinction between political practice and universal human morality and ethics. In the highest forum of Soviet society, at the Party Congress a year ago, we described our vision of the world, our philosophical concept of its present and its future. But we were not